Disclaimer! This is a non-profit educational video and is protected under fair use law. Ben 10 is created and owned by Warner Brothers, Cartoon Network, and Man of Action. Please support the official releases.
That's right, Ben 10. And I've come all this way to tell you that war just isn't cool. See, war never accomplishes anything. It's pointless and...
Get him!
Guys? Hey, if you want to get rough, how about a taste of Humongousaur?
LODESTAR!
LODESTAR is the Omnitrix's DNA sample of a Bio-Savarian, a magnetic-based species of an unknown planet of origin somewhere in the Ben 10 universe. Their bodies are made of an unknown living metal, with their heads balanced in between their horseshoe-like shoulders, keeping balance between the two poles as it floats. They also possess a robotic-like voice and sharp pincer-like hands, two of which LODESTAR focuses his attacks through. Just so you know.
LODESTAR! You sure turning into a magnet is the best move in a particle accelerator?
Beats me.
Speaking of his attacks...
Great segue, yay!
LODESTAR's main ability is, of course...
Magnetism!
My semblance is polarity.
No, not polarity, Pyrrha. Shut up. Bitch.
It could be worse. I'm not sure how, but I'm trying to keep a positive attitude.
LODESTAR possesses magnetokinesis and other magnetic-based powers. He can project magnetic fields that are capable of overloading electrical circuits and attracting magnetic materials. He can also telekinetically emit magnetic pulses that allow him to magnetize any ferromagnetic metals to move and throw them around. Basically anything magnetizable, or made of metal. He can attract and repel objects to smash into each other on command, effectively keeping things stuck together or far apart. Okay, let's be real here. Has anyone seen an X-Men movie? Yeah, he's Magneto. Except, probably much more in tune to his magnetic abilities. LODESTAR is literally a living magnet with incredible magnetic power. Hell, it's where his name comes from. Lodestone was one of the first magnetic irons ever discovered by scientists, and LODESTAR lives up to that, and then some.
I can't move! What black magic is this?
No magic! Just my natural magnetism!
LODESTAR can dismantle and reassemble metal devices, use his own power to fly by levitating himself, and control and bend metal to his will. Wow, just imagine of wanting to do something and just by thinking about it. Okay, yeah, we'll get to that. In any case, LODESTAR can create magnetic force fields for protection, and on the off chance he is damaged, he can effortlessly regenerate from mere chips and scraps by what Ben asserts to as...
magnets.
Yeah, sure. He can also generate...
magnetic blasts.
As he was going to use them to destroy the busy box with. More on that later. His magnetic abilities and alien physiology are even more amped by how the Omnitrix takes the prime of its species for Ben to use, the healthiest, most physically fit Bio-Savarian, with plenty of showcased examples.
My magnetic personality makes me more than a match for you!
LODESTAR physically has held back powerful robot appendages strong enough to punt Cannonbolt and break through Gwen's shields. He can effortlessly walk through a concrete wall and knock around superhuman opponents. And yes, that was a dream, but it was still Ben or Albedo's psyche making it believable, and Albedo's a genius, so, well, sort of, it's a long story. But as for LODESTAR's magnetism, which is much stronger than himself, he can lift a many number of things, especially when scaled to Ultimate Kevin, who took a good one-tenth of his powers, of which he could lift a steel beam and a 50-ton tank. Effortlessly, and that could just be one-tenth of his real power. But as for himself, he's thrown around Aggregor's robots like putties. Same with these Neo-Nightsies, eh? See what I did there? And a bunch of shipping containers. He's chucked a car across Undertown and lifted the entire Mr. Smoothie's parking lot against this giant thing, More on that later. He's destroyed and forced back dozens of Dimension 12 robots Forearms was fighting earlier. Jet Ray and Armadrillo have even done battle with these things and put up a good fight. He was even capable of breaking apart a Tekadon robot. For a time before the Omnitrix timed down due to technical issues.
What's that all about, Tennyson?
I don't know. It's never happened before. Where are all my aliens?
That function is not available.
Frickin' LTE. Okay, trust me on this, he totally would have had that down easy. In fact, they played as if that's the whole point. Tekadon robots can slug around Kevin and Gwen like nothing, where the two of them have needed Ben's help on multiple accounts. And those machines have been capable of going toe-to-toe with beings like Chroma Stone. LODESTAR totally could have taken it out. Feasibly. He's hit Ragnarok, this guy, not the Thor movie, with two metal doors and a two-ton car, and could equal out in power against his solar energy attacks, which, you guessed it, are a form of electromagnetic radiation. Kinda like how the Earth is protected from the sun's radiation by our own planet's magnetic field. I give that to him in the versatility category, but all of Ben's aliens are immune to radiation. Even the ones that are radiation. He's blocked a punch from this alien battlesuit careening down on top of him, after it already beat armored Kevin. He then hit it with trash and then Kevin's car before breaking it apart.
Every time.
Ugh. He's defeated a dragon robot with Kevin and has even magnetized a brain in a jar at the... Yeah, no really. But his strongest feat was when he went up against this thing. The Busy Box.
The Box!
Or more accurately known as a Nalgene Destructor, capable of learning, adapting, and copying the abilities and actions of whatever being it analyzes, sort of like a Mazo. LODESTAR, using all of his might, clearly at his limits, was able to pull this thing apart using all of his power, just in time for Gwen to grab the power source. This Nalgene Destructor was a 26-dimensional item owned by 26-dimensional beings. It's a level 20-plus tech device alongside the Omnitrix and the Annihilarg, both of which can destroy the entire universe on their own.
I did not mean to offend. It's just that you are such a young species. You only perceive three dimensions, is that right?
Yeah. How many are there?
Only 26 that matter.
Now granted, Kevin was capable of cracking this thing open multiple times, and he's now a solar system level hitter. But when Kevin took this thing down the first time, it broke into pieces, then to rebuild itself. But later, he was just lucky to get a crack in, proving its ability to superiorly adapt to its opponents, and God knows what if it kept going. This device was meant for 3-million-year-old multidimensional babies, and base form Gwen and Metamorpho Kevin could not take this thing down, neither could LODESTAR alone. They could have been killed, in the formative sense. It's likely it's mechanically adapted the abilities and artificial powers and stats of Humongousaur, Spider Monkey, and Kevin, but not Gwen, given mana is life energy, and that's the type of energy she uses. It's very unlikely this is going to put LODESTAR anywhere special, like at planet level, but it still does show his level of output and his limits. Which is still worth something, especially if what's already shown. I would put him at mountain level on a mid-end just because of this feat, but let's just keep going. LODESTAR's speed is quite impressive, but there's not many examples of it. He's been shown fast enough to attemptively counter non-metal throwing stars from a robot ninja. He's equaled Ragnarok's solar energy attacks, which are radiation that moves at the speed of light. His own attacks could be equal in that speed. He's caught pincers from that giant stalker robot who could fight and keep pace with almost all of Ben's aliens at once. This doesn't mean I think he's as fast as Brainstorm, though with his electromagnetic control, he could be faster than lightning or actually just ordinary light. Electric currents create magnetic fields, and magnetic fields exert forces on electrical fields and charges, so you don't care.
You don't know you're walking away. Wait a minute!
They could be similar in terms of versatile power and maybe even just speed. Magnetism is only one aspect of electromagnetism. It's in the name, and even on the wiki defining his magnetic blast, which could be equal to his attack speed. But his lowest speed would have to put him far above a supersonic advantage. He should be comparable to Kevin, who's dodged a radiation blast of light. Okay, taken from the last video. He's fought against laser shooting enemies multiple times, dodged attacks in human form, and could be scaled to light speed through friends and enemies he's defeated, or more or less the other aliens he stands beside. Admittedly, he doesn't really have a great track record in terms of speed, but in the episode Busy Box, he did move away from a laser attack, so faster than light. LODESTAR is incredibly durable. Lodestar can tank laser fire, bullet fire, and throwing stars. He's tanked and survived hits from the Stalker robot through several houses, and again, that thing has fought most of Ben's aliens, but admittedly, Lodestar could have been killed. In the formative sense. He's battled Generator Rex in their crossover episode and took attacks that Rex was dishing out all across New York, straight from the bridge to the mainland. His force fields have been used to deflect and protect from lasers and attackers and should be equal to his energy output. He's taken a hit from Dream Aggregor that sent his head flying into a car and he was completely fine. And speaking of Aggregor, segue, yay! His most impressive feat was surviving Aggregor's ship exploding right in his face, reducing him to mere scraps, to then of which he reformed later, barely miffed.
Ben, how did you...
Magnets. For what it's worth, you were right about the trap thing.
According to a Versus Battle Wiki user post by Demonic Dude, using an equation called the Fireball Formula, and by comparing the pixel scaling of the mountains in the background to the mushroom cloud itself, this explosion was measured at a whopping 630 megatons of TNT. What?
What? What the fuck?
That's 12 times more powerful than the Tsar Bomba, the most powerful nuke in the world. I know it doesn't look like it, considering it's not, like, destroying everything, but that's just how physics work in animated shows. This is even confirmed by Demonic Dude himself in a messaging conversation I had with him, saying that this fireball formula has been used since 2015 and is 100% approved by longtime Versus Battle members and experts, Spinosaurus 75 fan, and Dragoo. The Ben 10 universe even has stronger nukes and explosions within its own canon, some of which Ben can survive perfectly. But still, with the Nalgene Destructor feat scaling from there, it's completely believable to say that this could be Lodestar's absolute physical limit. And yes, he didn't physically survive the bomb, but he reformed from what remaining pieces he had quite easily in a similar way how other fictional characters tank explosions so long as they have enough of their pieces still remaining to regenerate. The link to his blog is in the description, and please go follow Demonic Dude on Twitter and on his Versus Battle Wiki page. He was really helpful on this, and I appreciate it. He's awesome, and I suck at math. This blast, taken in its nuclear calculation, could potentially be 10 gigatons of TNT, but that's never specifically stated within the episode, so we're only doing by what the explosion itself is measured at, not what kind it isn't stated to be, which is nuclear.
Shrek!
Oh, come on, Donkey, look at him in his wee little boots. You know, how many cats can we-
Magnets!
Oh, right! Oh, right! Yeah, the versatility category. He can use his body as a compass? Maybe? For real, I'm pretty sure I've gone over all of his magnetic control and versatility already, right? Well, actually, wait, no, I have a few notes here. Let me flip through this. I need glasses. He can survive in the vacuum of space without air, he doesn't need food, and is apparently immortal, says the Versus Battle Wiki page. Makes sense, considering he's literally made of magnets. He possesses sharp, versatile appendages. He can sense magnetic materials and magnetic fields when consistent, allowing him to perceive direction, altitude, or location, essentially mapping himself out, helped by that compass quote earlier. He can create magnetic blasts, magnetic waves, can focus his magnetic forces to break apart specific parts of an object. He's attracted and repelled metal weapons dozens of times before. He can create magnetic forces to rip apart robots that Kevin has trouble defeating. He can dismantle complex objects and just freeze machines in place.
In the video game, The Rise of Hex, Lodestar defeated Hex in combat and somehow managed to seal him within his own metal medallion. How the hell did he do that? Is he magic? Magnets? Magnets.
He can create magnetic poles and force fields and look, just simple magneto stuff. We'll get to that in a minute. Let's just tally this up. For strength, he's lifted tanks and cars with relative ease and can fight enemies base level Gwen and Kevin can't take on, as well as equaling on Ragnarok and other heavy hitter threats, putting him at a small city level of output, and even greater at a large mountain level if we scale the Nalgene Destructor feat or Kevin's feats. He's physically held back the Stalker's robotic limbs that can break through Gwen's shields and punt cannon bolts, so city level isn't out of the question. For speed, he's more likely than not transonic, or at supersonic speeds in combat. But much as other aliens and characters in the Ben 10 universe, he could just be capable of faster-than-light speeds moving away from the Nalgene Destructor's laser attacks, or scaling from Ben, Gwen, and Kevin respectively, despite the fact that he was cornered by a hailstorm of lasers in his first appearance. He was just getting the hang of it, and Data dumps a bitch. For durability, he's tanked laser fire and other heavy hitters. Aggregor's ship explosion equaled over 600 megatons of force, so in terms of his physical durability, he can withstand his magnetic parts surviving that much force. But his force fields should be equal to his magnetic abilities, at small city level, or even greater, large mountain level. For versatility, his magnetokinesis, electromagnetokinesis, magnetoreception, which is sensing magnetic materials and fields, magnetotelekinesis, magnetic dismantlement, magnetic force field generation, levitation, flight, magnetic regeneration, sharp claws, space survivability, and ferrokinesis... Pyrrha would be proud.
Die, you stupid bitch!
Nah, I'm just kidding, I ship it. Send me your fan art, seriously. His weaknesses are those that follow. Number 1, his head. If his head is disconnected from his body, he won't be able to perform properly. Hehe. This is shown in Ben/Albedo's dream where this happened, basically leaving his body blinded and wandering around. He can also attract his body to his head to make sure it stays where it is, but this still leaves him vulnerable to being thrown around and exhausted. He does apparently still feel pain, though for some aliens it's either not a problem or Ben just has incredible willpower. Number 2, non-magnetic materials. Items like throwing stars or the stalker were non-magnetic, which makes Lodestar's job much more difficult in a fight. Obviously, he'd need to either rely on the environment for an advantage, or... he's fucked. And that's it, really. Well, this was a pretty straightforward read. How about we fix that? This theoretical section is really more to go into Lodestar's powers on a level that Ben hasn't thought to use them at, or hasn't used yet in order to gauge his power fairly without fanfictioning everything. We've gone on to talk about how Lodestar has the scaled ability to level city blocks with his magnetic powers and can control magnetic fields, but let's see what he can really do when scaled to... Magneto of the Marvel Universe can do many things, like lift the Golden Gate Bridge, catch bullets, and topple a mountain. Now, before anyone says it in the comments, am I saying that in a death battle of Magneto versus Lodestar, Lodestar wins?
Fuck no!
He can control metal on such a level that he recreates his costume by pulling metal from the air, and is controlling the entire planet's electromagnetic field, something Lodestar can't really do himself. This is really more a way to scale in the abilities of other characters on a level to make sense of Lodestar's capabilities, considering how he's taken down 3 robots that were so unstoppable they could have leveled Bellwood and beat Kevin and Gwen all by themselves, and this supports Lodestar's capable output. If Lodestar can strain to pull apart a multidimensional device's chest piece, I'm pretty sure he can do this. Give or take. Magneto can also manipulate water and blood and control other objects and people off the ground. Manipulate the electromagnetic spectrum to turn invisible or project any form of energy. And manipulate matter on the molecular level. Probably not something in Lodestar's repertoire, but considering how he can manipulate electromagnetic energy and block Ragnarok's solar energy rays, he could possibly be capable of doing those things on some sort of shorter level, theoretically. The data dump and Ben's impossibility with other transformations makes his versatility widen up to an impossible horizon. I hope. I know people would have wanted me to compare to someone like Magneto, so there, I did it. There's not much of anyone else with magnetic abilities to scale up from there, so let's just get to the roundup.
My semblance is polarity.
Shut up! Love you. In short, Lodestar is one of Ben's most powerful and versatile aliens with so much more potential packed from within. With his incredible magnetic strength, holy regenerative ability, and ungodly amounts of versatility, Lodestar is one of Ben's best distance fighters, who Ben will always need when the going gets tough against a mechanical enemy or metal-based opponent. So whether there's a need for something to be torn apart or put back together, we can always rely on Lodestar's magnetic personality to pull us through. Or, you know, just be a cool refrigerator magnet idea. How has no one made that yet? Etsy, get on that, seriously. Because that's what Lodestar does. He pulls us together. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Please be sure to follow me on my social media and subscribe to both this channel and my main filmmaking channel. And please feel free, if you will, to be sure to correct me on anything I got wrong in this video or missed out on in the comments below. I'll probably make a corrections video down the line. Another special thanks to Demonic Dude for his help on this. Please show him some love and tune in next time where I go into the powers and abilities of the next alien, Goop! Yep, it's flubber time. Please let me know in the comments what you'd want to see. Like, share, comment, and subscribe, the works. Happy trails!